Hi all, welcome to the new course on measurements. So today's class we are going to see overview of the course and how I am going to proceed. So first let us see what is the syllabus that is given for the GATE 2021. This is the syllabus I have downloaded from that website. They have given the syllabus is bridges and potentiometers, measurement of voltage, current, power, energy and power factor, instrument transformers, digital voltmeters and multimeters, phase, time and frequency measurements, oscilloscopes and error analysis. So just they discussed briefly only. Let us see what will be the detailed syllabus and how we are going to proceed in the coming sections. So I am dividing this entire syllabus into multiple modules, and each module I will try to keep the different color for the slide so that you can easily identify between the modules. So I am dividing this entire thing into 10 modules. So first module we are starting with the errors and accuracy. So as part of this we are going to see about static error, static calibration and error calibration curve. What are the different errors? They are limiting errors, relative limiting errors, different types of errors, that is gross error, systematic error, random or residual errors. Then after that we will see accuracy and the precision. This is the most commonly asked question in the interview. If you tell in the interview that your favorite subject is measurements, because most of the people confuse what is the difference between accuracy and the precision. So this we are going to detail in see in detail, because this is most commonly asked question when you go for some interviews. Then after that we will see sensitivity, linearity, hysteresis, what is threshold, what is a dead time and the dead zone. After that we will see about what is resolution of the instrument, what is loading effect. So after that we will briefly discuss about different measurement standards. So with this we will complete the basics. So here this chapter is little bit confusing in the entire measurements, because it is little bit theoretical. So that's why I want to discuss this in a detailed way, and that too a precise and non-confusing way. So that's why this may take a little more time. So after that we will go for electrical and magnetic measurements as module number 2. So first we will see about introduction to what is the electrical and magnetic measurements. So first we will see D. Arsonval galvanometer, moving iron type, moving coil type, electrodynamometer type, electrostatic instruments, induction type instruments, and after that we will see the application of these instruments for measurements of voltage, current, power and energy. So those things we will discuss in detail for single phase as well as three phase. So after that we will go to the next module, that is resistance measurements. In the resistance measurements we are going to see different methods of measurements of low, medium and high resistance, then measurement of earth resistance, localization of cable faults by using Murray and Verley loop test. So this Murray and Verley loop test is already discussed in cables topic in power systems, but here again we will discuss from the measurements point of view. So after that we will go for measurement of the inductance and capacitance. So this measurement of inductance and capacitance we will measure by using AC bridge methods, and we will discuss about what is Q factor, what is dissipation factor, what are the sources of errors in the bridge circuits, and what are the different methods of reducing the errors in the bridge. So after that we will see Wagner earthing device also, which also comes under this category only. So after that we will discuss about measurement of power factor and frequency. So as part of this we are going to discuss about single phase and three phase electrodynamometer type power factor meter, moving iron power factor meters, types of frequency meters, that they are mechanical resonance type, electrical resonance type, ratio meter type and Western frequency meter. So these things we will discuss here. So after that we will go for the potentiometers. So in the potentiometers we will discuss about DC potentiometer circuit. So modern form of DC potentiometers, measurement of voltage, current, resistance and calibration of voltmeter and ammeter using potentiometers. When already other type of instruments are there, why should we go for the potentiometers? What are the advantages? Why they are used as a standard meters? That means they are used for standardizing or calibrating any new instrument that is designed. So those details we are going to see in this chapter. So voltage ratio box, AC potentiometers and their applications. So these things we will discuss in detail. So after that next module will be instrument transformers. So instrument transformer we are going to see how the instrument transformers are used, what are the basic terminologies, the different instrument transformers, that is CT and PT, what are the different errors and how to decrease them. So these topics also already discussed in the transformers playlist, but here again we will see from the instrument point of view in briefly, or if the lectures are already so much more, then I will just provide the link which is already provided in the Transformers playlist only. Because by this time you will understand all the basics, you will be able to follow these instrument transformers easily from there. So after that we will see about cathode ray oscilloscope, which is also called as CRO. So we are going to see first about what is cathode ray tube. So how the display of electrical signal can be done in the CRO. So using those signals, how we can make the measurement of voltage, current, phase difference and frequency, how to measure using cathode ray oscilloscope. So after that we will go for electronic or digital instruments. So we are going to see electronic voltmeter, or which is we call as digital voltmeter, digital multimeter, LCR meter and the Q meter. So only these things will be discussed. So after that we will discuss about the transducers. So in transducers we are going to see classification of the transducers, mechanical devices are primary detectors, basics requirement of the transducers. Then we will see electrical transducers, types of transducer for measuring the displacement, strain, vibration, pressure, flow, temperature, force, torque, liquid level, humidity, pH value, velocity, acceleration, and basic principle of residual transducers, inductive transducers, capacitive transducers, thermoelectric transducers, piezoelectric transducers, and what is Hall effect transducer, electromechanical transducers and photoelectric transducers. And after that we will discuss briefly about digital transducers also. So this is the basic syllabus that is required both when you are preparing for the IES or GATE or even for the other competitive exams. So I am limiting my measurements discussion to these topics. So in future, if the time permits, so then we will try to expand once all the courses are over. So as of now, I am going to only discuss these topics in part of the measurements. So what are the standard books you have to follow? So the reference books for this one, so because this is called as the Bible for the measurements, because this is electrical and electronic measurement and instrumentations by A.K. Shahane. This is the standard book. And the second book which I am going to follow is Electrical and Electronic Measurements and Instrumentation by R.K. Rajput. Actually, he is a mechanical engineer. So he discusses all the measurements from the mechanical point of view or from a Raman point of view. That means you can easily understand each and every topic if you are following this book. And the last book is Electrical Measurements and Measuring Instruments by G.B. Gupta. So these are the three basic books which I am going to follow. Like for example, for chapter number 1, that is Errors and Analysis, so it is better explained in Electrical Measurements, this J.B. Gupta book. So, but for the remaining topics, generally I prefer to go for either A.K. Shahane, R.K. Rajput or J.B. Gupta. I will mention in the beginning of the respective chapters. So along with that, I am going to provide the complete handwritten material also. So I will try to upload the material after completing every 2-3 lectures. So let me show you how to download the material or how to see my channel, effectively utilize my channel. So if you open my channel, my channel will display like this. So in this channel, so don't get confused. If you want to see the playlist, where you have to go, you have to go to the playlist. So playlist tab is there here. When you click the playlist tab, you can see all the playlists are displaying here. Like this measurement playlist also going to add here. Let us assume you want to download the material of a particular playlist. So for that, let us take for example, I am going to power electronics. So in the power electronics, I have gone. So when you go inside, if you go down, this section is called as the descriptive section. So in the description section, because this section will not come if you are opening in the mobile. If you are opening in the mobile, you have to click on the this topic name. Like for example, PE01 Introduction to Power Electronics. This is my lecture name. So click on the lecture name, then this will expand like this. This much expansion will be done. So below that, I have provided link for the material. So there will be Google Drive link. Just click on the link. So once you click on the link, that link will open. So here I will go on updating the material after completing every 3-4 lectures. So like this. So depending on the size, because maximum limit how much you can download easily, accordingly I will divide into modules and the respective modules will be uploaded here. So you can download from here. So in this way you can use it. Let us assume if you have a doubt. So in that case, you can just click here and add a public comment here. So whenever you add the comment, it will come to my mail. So I will see your comment. So I will revert back to your reply. So whenever I give the reply, like for example, this student has asked something. So I have given the reply here. You can see. So whenever I give the reply, so it will automatically come to your mail also. So you need not open the mail and check again. That means if you are giving any comment here, so I will reply to it and that reply will come to your mail as well. So let us assume within 2 days, if you are not getting reply from me, because sometimes what happens, the Google, depending on what words you are typing, sometimes they send your comment into spam. So I don't get the notification. So if I am not getting the response within 2 days, So you just keep the request once again. That means you comment once again. So in that case, it will come to me. So you just comment with a different type of language. It rarely happens, but some people has complained that I am not responding to them. The reason is generally Google keeps in block list if some unusual words are used in keeping the question. So you can please ask here and I will reply from there. I hope what is the basic procedure and how to go, how to download the material and these basics are clear to you. So next class onwards, so I am going to start the module number 1, that is error analysis. So error analysis, I am mainly following the JB Gupta book. So once the error analysis is over, then I will go for chapter by chapter. So along with this, I want to tell you, along with this subject, as I am running power electronics also in parallel, so I will teach chapter by chapter alternately. That means I will complete chapter number 1 of measurements. After that, I will complete one chapter of the power electronics. Then I will come back to this so that both will run parallelly. Getting it? So if you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.